because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options and completing the pass anyway.
To throw on second to Simeon. And oh, he took that hit one-handed. What a grab. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Room to run past midfield. The 40. 20. And he makes it all the way down to the 13-yard line. A huge play there for Denver. 49 yards. From the red zone now, Simeon. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he'll be knocked down sideways at the one-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So now it's first and goal. Of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal. Now it's Simeon. Wasn't able to get. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. And Quan Bolden, his second touchdown on the season. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about three steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a two-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Back here with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaughan. We've had the kickoff to begin the first quarter. Now it's time for the second quarter kickoff, as he'll take over with the ball first and 10. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows in this game.
Now it's Taylor. They're unable to connect. What? A late flag comes in.
Oh, he's shit, man. Too early. No one's even touching.
Aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
They go play action here on first down. Going deep for Benjamin. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And attempted a deep ball there, and they didn't get it. But boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. On second down, it's McCoy. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. Gain of 26 on the third down conversion. But nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion. Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Taylor now off the bootleg. Wide open receiver complete.
Wide on that.
Bills touchdown. So the quarterback drops to throw, looks over, and boom, a guy that wide open, he has to be thinking, wait a minute, this is some kind of a dream. This is too easy.
Yeah, a great dream. One you don't want to wake up from, but for the defense, almost feels like there's a bust in coverage.
Steven Hauschka for the point after. Sunday night game, matchup you don't see very often, a rematch of Super Bowl 18. The Raiders traveling to Washington, and then tomorrow on Monday night, we'll see the Cowboys heading to the desert to take on the Cardinals.
Former NFC East rivals.
And the D-line pitching to get it on, expecting to run. Simeon. A dump off to Anderson. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Now Thomas will come in motion right. Their plans on fourth down. Now the second-year man from Syracuse, Riley Dixon, on the punt, as he's on the punt for the first time this afternoon. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And a big tackle there as the defender runs right through it at the 16. A first scoring update now from Carolina. And it's the Panthers there out to the early advantage. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout.
Here we go!
A fake to McCoy. Now it's Taylor. Flushed out right. On the run. He'll let it go deep. Yeah. Right sideline. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Second and 10, it's Taylor again. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Charles Clay as tight end, and it's third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Here we go! What? Ohio! 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 Ohio!
Taylor now on third down. Eluding the pressure right. Taylor able to use those legs of his to pick up a first.
Now that definitely hurts, because the mindset is getting a three and out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Here we go! Back round! Back round!
Taylor with a give to McCoy. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Taylor. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Von Miller coming in hard on the blitz. He gets him down for a loss of four.
I give thanks every day that I never had to play offensive line in the NFL and have to try and block Von Miller.
He was second only to Vic Beasley last year with 13 and a half sacks.
Ohio! Ohio!
Third and long, it's Taylor. Complete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
And definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Colton Schmidt, fourth-year man from UC Davis, on to punt it away as he's on to punt for Buffalo. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. On fourth down, Colton Schmidt to punt it away.
Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Schmidt on to punt as he sends it away. This is taken around the 12. Excellent work on the run back there, 33 yards. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. They start the drive with Anderson. And an alley to run. And he's brought down. Solid gain of 18 yards and a Denver first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit, thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think there he had to come off of his primary receiver in a big way, just trying to get it to a secondary guy, unable to get that play completed.
Check down, but didn't even have enough time to do that. Incomplete. Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four.
if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
Pass falls incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember.
Those really long field goals, when they are made, they are things of beauty. But there is a danger to getting them started, isn't there?
Yeah, with that low drive, you've got to really keep it low to the ground, don't you, to get that distance.
Yeah, hard to just pop it up in the air, because otherwise it's not going to get there. So you've got to drive it low in order to have the distance. And that usually puts it in jeopardy, gives them a chance to block it. And everyone knows it on the other side. That's when you get your best jumpers on the other side of the field to try and get up and get it. With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Buffalo after this. The Bills on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 15. From the gun, it's Taylor. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Meanwhile, a second quarter score from Carolina, and it's the Panthers there out to the early advantage. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Instead, he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. No gain on the play there, 2nd down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is, and really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game, because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Fuck. Bad throw.
Should have had it. 3rd down now.
Oh man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. The Broncos on 3rd down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10.
What the fuck, man? That's a shitty play. Play is a good play, but why is he picking his own player?
They don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force him into a likely punting situation.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And they're going to go soft on the corners.
Let's go! Red 38! Red 38!
To throw on second down, Taylor. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free, then brings up third down.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the screen. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down.
He's so multi-talented, isn't he? He can catch the ball, not just on screens, as we saw there. Get him out into open field. He makes big-time plays. Had 50 catches a year ago.
Yeah, and even 50, that was the most he's had since 2013. To throw is Taylor. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to get it to LeSean McCoy, and that'll bring up second down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
It really turned it loose, didn't it? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
Here we go.
Here's Taylor to throw on third down. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Yeah, he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That's a 43-yard punt, aided as well by a loss on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Around the NFL, they're in the second in Philly. And that's now a 2-touchdown game as the Eagles have scored again. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half.
Assignment that really gets you into more trouble.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
All right, here we go.
On the counter, it's Charles. And he's going to be taken down here, as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we come upon halftime with the visiting Broncos taking the lead in the locker room as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards, as he'll get this only back to the 20. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here, as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They had a big first half. Now they have a chance to add to that lead here in the opening possession of the second half.
And everyone always asks about halftime adjustments, kind of the key phrase. What did you do at halftime? Well, the way they ran offense in the first half, I think they were very calm, congratulatory, but also what they were saying is, don't expect them to be the same on defense. They'll be the ones making the adjustments. Let's see what they do, and we'll attack accordingly.
And we'll see how they attack here. On first down, it's Semien. He goes underneath for Anderson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Denver has the first down to play, going for 15 yards.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. it's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to them back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Second down following the run. They run it again with Anderson. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Time running out here on the play clock. The Broncos on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and seven. They'll bring the tight end in motion right.
I just wanted to punt it, man. I didn't mean to do that.
And in comes the flag.
But I do it if it's less than five.
Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for Denver. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. So here's the Bills offense. Now they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. It seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. They'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. But on that play, they held him to a short gain.
And this will be incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Come on, let's go!
On third down, Taylor. Now he's got his man. It's the tight end play. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. A good pick up there at 20 yards.
That's bullshit. Where's my fucking chance?
Let's check in with our referee.
Watch left, watch left. Tight end to the left.
second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. He'd pick up another first down with that run.
Come on, let's go!
Throwing now, Taylor on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Now they'll throw with Taylor. Flush to his right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the corner.
No way! I stayed in the end zone. Fuck that. I didn't even do nothing.
Felt like his own gyroscope really got out of whack, didn't it? Going backwards into your own end zone after such a great play. Totally disoriented and gave him 2 points.
I should just let the fucking computer do it.
Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the end of the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's all they can get it done.
Here we go. One,
on first down, it's Taylor. Being chased out left. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Taylor. And that is going to be incomplete. The Bills drive stalls out on fourth down. And the Broncos will take over on downs. So the Broncos coming out now. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. And a big tight end shifting around. On 2nd down, Anderson. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He lost 2 there. And it's 3rd down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well. On 2nd down and short, what I like to say. Yeah, without a doubt, I thought that was a great spot to call it. instead, didn't go their way, did it?
Now, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Here we go now.
They're trying to show you they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Got a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. C.J. Anderson with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Broncos will extend their lead. A shotgun snap for Simeon. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. McManus on to kick this one off. This is taken about 7 yards deep.
That makes it three possessions. I had to.
Not by much as he's
gotta do that shit.
Back onto the field now comes the Bills offense. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start and rebuild that confidence.
That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And that's going to make it second and 14. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. Forced out to his left. And some space here. Back now in Buffalo. The Bills have the football, but they trail here as we begin quarter number four. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Come on, let's run!
He'll throw on first down with Taylor. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. First down screen pass, good for five.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Here we go!
Now Taylor to throw on second down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
They find some open field here. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
On third down, the defense decided to blitz. A very good job of recognizing it, stepping away from the pressure, and finding open space to scramble and pick up a first down.
Here's Taylor. Flushed out right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. A rough couple of weeks for the man under center. 5 sacks last week, 4 now this week. Do you try to design some quicker developing plays with your offensive coordinator?
I think you do that. I think you also change his launch point at times. In other words, move your pocket to the right, to the left, roll him out, bootleg it, do some different things so they can't just rely on the fact that he's going to take 3 to 5 steps back in the pocket and line up and throw the football.
Yeah, current formula is not working right now. Taylor on first down. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a first down again. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball. When you put up a token press, make sure you get up there and make them eat up.
And he is in the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown.
Well, if you've got him in your fantasy league, you like his production, a second touchdown of the game. But right now, his team is trailing. Fortunately, he's playing pretty well and trying to keep him in it.
Yeah, they might need a little more from him.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they continue to call his number. Right now, he needs his defense to step up and give him a chance.
Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Here's Anderson as they begin this series on the ground. And all the way down to the 39. A big time run there by Anderson. 42 yards. Now a play fake here on first down. This one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Good pick up there of 20 yards. Quite the turnaround from a week ago where he threw 4 interceptions. He hasn't had an interception this game, and he told us during the week, my goal, goose egg. He's achieving that so far.
And what we're seeing is a guy that you can win with, all right? Because anyone who can make that type of an adjustment to shake off a really horrendous week the week before and come back and play mistake-free football to this point, yeah, that's a guy I want to play with, that's for sure.
On second down, here's Simeon. His throw incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Now Simeon steps away to his left. Oh, no, he lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bills. Look at the big man rumble. He's at the 50, the 30, past the 20, 10. And this is going to be brought back for a Bills touchdown.
No fucking interceptions, and then he does that. Oh.
Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. Like they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. You know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? This definitely qualifies.
And you can bet they're bringing 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. They'll be looking to make amends for the events of a moment ago. A fumble return for 6 points.
You absolutely have to protect the football. That's got to be priority number 1 because margin for error is starting to slip away. Now it's down to a 1-score game.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Start the drive with Jamal Charles. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. See if they stay on the ground for a second down. Simeon It's intercepted. Picked off by Preston Brown, the linebacker. Critical error there in a tight game.
Oh, man.
On second and short. Again, it's McCoy. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
What we're seeing from the defense here is a group of guys bearing down, trying to help out their quarterback after he threw an interception. Good stops on the first two downs. It brings up a key third down.
Now McCoy. And he gets him a little bit closer and takes it from the six inside the five to the four. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four.
Here we go.
Taylor will throw. Four times in the game already, and they're the holding goal.
And you know darn well the offensive line coach is frustrated and upset that he's been hit that many times already. He doesn't really care that they hold now. Just don't let him get hit anymore.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Yardage back to the 15. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Offense, they get set to head back onto the field. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now, but let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. And it worked his way across the 30 to the 32. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
And that's a nice gain by him on first down, picking up some key yardage.
Watch it now, Marty. Here we go now.
Here's Simeon now on second down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. Offense comes to the line now, first and ten. Second down. Simeon now to throw. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll get up near the 45. He'll spot it at the 44. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Motion left goes Sanders. Short yardage situation. Here's Charles. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of 46. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down. Now Simeon. He's got a man. It's his fullback. Calling a pickup of 7, and that'll make it second down.
And that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
So just about a minute to go here, tie ball game.
As fans, we love free football. But the guys in the field don't. They're going to attack and go for the win right now.
Juke move that gives him the first down. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down. A first down carry here for Charles. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Simeon going to rush his guys to the line. Second is Simeon. Blitz coming, and down he goes. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Good game, man.
And it'll be all smiles on Blake Street tonight. The Broncos have won it. But Charles, we saw a comeback bid fall just a little short, but give them credit. They were able to hold on, withstand that comeback, and ultimately win it.
Ooh, good game.
Bottom line, when it's all said and done, they don't ask you how much you won by. They just want to know, did you win? And that they did.
So for the Broncos, they get back in the win column as they move to 2-1 now on the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the Oakland Raiders. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup with the Falcons. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we say so long from Buffalo.